morning. Today we are going to see Newton's second law. In last class we have seen Newton's first law. In continuation, it is second law. First I will read the definition, after that I will explain. It states that the rate of change of momentum of a body is directly proportional to the external force applied on it. Okay, and the change in momentum takes place in the direction of the applied force. Okay, here we are introducing one word called momentum. Science students will be knowing this term, but for commerce students also and some humanities students also watching these videos, therefore I want to explain this term momentum, what's meant by momentum, and some basic concepts I'll explain here. Okay, first I'll explain what's meant by momentum, after that I'll go through the definition. Okay, momentum is denoted by the letter P. Okay, it is equal to mass into velocity. Momentum equal to mass into velocity, and I will define further some terms. Okay, now what's meant by a velocity? Velocity is usually we say speed. Okay, what is the speed of the vehicle? What is the speed of the car? What is the speed of the bike? Just like, okay, speed means it is a scalar quantity. That means it measures the magnitude only. Okay, 50 kilometer. Okay, per hour. Now, if you say 50 kilometer per hour in east direction, then it is called velocity. Usually, in day-to-day life, we speak about speed. That is scalar quantity. But velocity is a vector quantity. We have to say 50 kilometer per hour in north direction, in west direction, in front direction, just like. Then it is called velocity. Okay. Now, what's meant by velocity? Velocity is ds by dt. Ds by dt. That means, I'll define that also. Rate of change of displacement. Rate of change of displacement. Whenever you define some term and it starts with rate of, that means dt is there in the denominator. Dt is there in the denominator. Therefore, here ds is the displacement. That means an object is here and it is displayed in this direction. Okay. That means you are measuring the distance as well as you are mentioning the direction. Okay. In which direction? In east or west? Okay. You are mentioning the direction. Then it is called a displacement. Now, in how much distance, sorry, how much time the displacement takes place. Okay. Then it is called velocity. Therefore, velocity is defined as ds by dt. Rate of change of displacement. And I am going to define another term called acceleration. Okay. Acceleration means it dv by dt. It is dv by dt. Here we define velocity first and then we are defining acceleration. And in bike or everybody knows accelerator. That means it is used to increase the velocity or decrease the velocity. If it is increasing means it is an acceleration. If it is decreasing means it is a retardation. Okay. Now here acceleration is defined as rate of change of velocity. Again, I am saying rate of change of. That means in denominator, dt is there. Okay, dt and dv. In how much time the velocity changes from one value to another value. That is called acceleration. That means from 30 to 40. 30 kilometer per hour to 40 kilometer per hour. Then it is increasing. If it is 50 to 40, then the velocity is decreasing. Then you can put minus acceleration or simply you can say retardation. Okay. Now these terms we defined. Okay. What's meant by acceleration? What's meant by velocity? And what's meant by momentum? Momentum means mass into velocity. Now let us define what happens here. Okay. okay, what happens to this
momentum?
Okay, I'll erase this. Here, the definition is Newton's second law states that rate of change of momentum. I already told you, whenever the word rate comes, then in the denominator you have to put dt. Okay, now change of momentum. Momentum means p, change of momentum means dp. Therefore, dp. Okay, therefore, dp by dt, rate of change of momentum. Change of momentum, rate of. Therefore, rate of change of momentum is of a body is directly proportional to the external force applied. Okay, that means F is proportional to dp by dt. Okay, this is the equation for this second law. Okay, now I'll explain again. Rate of change of momentum. Rate of change of momentum is proportional to external force applied. Okay, now this proportionality is there. Now if you want to convert into equation, then you have to put one constant, okay, k dp by dt. Now if you put, if you take k equal to 1, then simply F is equal to dp by dt. Okay, this is the equation for Newton's second law. Now I am coming to this red line, okay, and the change in momentum takes place in the direction of the applied force. Change in momentum takes place in the direction of the applied force. I'll give you an example. This momentum takes place in which direction you are applying force. Okay. Now, see here. He is a bowler in cricket. Okay. He is a batsman. Okay. Now he throws a ball. Now he is having a bat. And the ball is coming with a velocity. That means mass should be there for a ball. Therefore, you take the mass. And the ball is coming with a velocity. Therefore, you take the velocity as V1. Okay. That means the bowler is throwing a ball. Therefore, the ball is coming with a velocity V1. Now, the batsman applies his force. Okay. Therefore, he hits the ball and the ball is moving with higher velocity. Now, you take the velocity as V2. Therefore, the change in momentum, is mass into V2 minus mass into V1. This is the change in momentum. Okay, because momentum I told you, mass into velocity. Now this is after batting. This is before batting. Now mass is common. Therefore you can take mass common V2 minus V1. Now this is momentum, change in momentum. This is P. Okay. And here this is change in momentum. You can take change in momentum you are mentioning. Therefore you can put dp also. Okay. Therefore you put dp here. You can put dp here. And with the time, therefore you can put dp by dt, which is equal to this force. Okay. Now you understand. He is throwing a ball. Ball is coming with a velocity. And he bats. Therefore the ball is moving with a higher velocity. Therefore velocity changes. That means we are telling momentum changes, because that velocity depends upon the mass of the ball also. Okay. Therefore, here we are telling change in momentum depends on the force of external applied force. Okay. Now this direction here, the change in momentum takes place in the direction of the applied force. In which direction he is hitting the ball? Okay, in that direction only the ball will move. Okay, that is the meaning of this. Change in momentum takes place in the direction of the applied force. Okay, now here this law is used to measure the force. Okay, this law is used to measure the force. How it is measured? Again, we take this formula only. Okay, we take this formula. It is very simple concept. Okay, force equal to dp by dt. Force equal to dp by dt. Now, what is dp? Dp equal to, or what is p? You substitute for p. P equal to mass into velocity. Mass into velocity by dt. Now, mass is common. Sorry, mass is constant. Therefore, you take constant. Therefore, mass into dv by dt. Okay. Here, f is there. This equation we derived using this. Rate of change of momentum is equal to applied force. And here for p, we are substituting mass into velocity. Mass is constant. Therefore, we have taken outside. And dv by dt, just now I have defined. It is an acceleration. Therefore, force equal to mass into acceleration. Because a equal to dv by dt. Okay. Now, this is the important equation. Okay. They will ask, derive an equation for measure of a force. Then you have to defend Newton's second law. And then you have to derive this equation. After that, you have to apply this. And you have to finally bring this equation. Okay. Force equal to mass into acceleration. It is an important equation. We are going to apply in many numerical problems. Okay. Thank you.